So hello and welcome to another episode from the Advanced Business Show, where we sit down with you each week to talk with you about some topics that will help you get advanced in your career, in your business, and in your life. In this week episode, we have a really nice topic, which is data science and big data, which we will tell you about this new trend in business. That is like changing how the business look like and how people are like or how business actually is looking toward their data. And also we will talk about the TikTok acquiring deal in the US, and we will like show you some other information related, or sorry, show you the book recommendation that will help you in this understanding more about the today episode. So now let's start with the news segment and let's look at the TikTok deal. Now TikTok deal is starting and almost getting acquired by some tech giant in the US, and like it is trying to do some changes to its deal so it meets some demands from the US administration. Now I'm not gonna like make it long for you, but it's like this, the TikTok success and so on is like, let's say it's the dream of each startup, each app out there. They like start out, they penetrate the market, they have a nice let's call it a number of users, they grow like maybe 50 million, 100 million, and so on. So then they later on get acquired by some tech giant, and there are many examples of this getting acquired of similar deals with many apps. For example, there was the Vine app, which as unfortunately was shut down. What also we can look at the Instagram app as well. Instagram was acquired by Facebook, and so on. So like reaching this state is literally each and every app a dream, because like for it will generate massive income and massive money for them. So hopefully our guests or our listeners will be able to create such apps and like reach it to the getting acquired by giants, maybe do some IPOs and so on, which is something that is very popular with today startups and technology apps. And remember, like there is always a chance for everyone in everything. So don't say no, I will not do it. No, you have, everybody has some fair chance. So now, let's talk about our own main topic in this episode, which is data science and big data. Now, when we say data science, what we are talking about? We are talking about the way we are analyzing data using some mathematical representation and some equations to help us understand the common patterns that is going on inside like some consumer behavior. For example, let's say that I have a data set of people buying clothes from an online retailer in a website. Okay, so now what I do, I apply some mathematical equations to it, some data analysis to it, to see how or if there is any patterns that is happening maybe in the cold months. For example, in the cold months, if you do some analysis, you will see that the people tend to buy more and more warm clothes at the cold months for sure. So like, but maybe they start buying early of this like maybe earlier a month from the actual cold months. Okay. So these like pattern analysis and the pattern or what we call it the data science, which we take a look at the data stored and like analyze them mathematically, will help us see what's recurring and what's happening inside some data set, and will help us to find patterns inside that data. Now, data science it has like many tools. There are many tools if you want to analyze your data and understand it and know what's going on with it. Now, some of the popular tool I will give you right now, which is R. R is like a language that is used to analyze the data and see what's happening like inside it. You can oh, sleepy. So you can like analyze the data, see with R, like analyze maybe the upper, let's call it orders, for a certain area or certain period of time. For example, Uber can like look at New York City and say like in New York City on the period from 8 to 10 a.m. we have the most amount of users or amount of riders, so we need to have some extra maybe drivers and so on. Also, they can like maybe try to maybe try to match the let's call it the shorter path for the rider, like so like give him a much better price. Also, like they pay less and they have more satisfied customer and so on. There are many use cases for data science. You need to maybe sit down with your IT department or someone like that and analyze this data. Also, we have some other tools as Taboola, and also it help you in such things in the representation of data and so on. And there are many tools out there available for you to analyze your data set. Now, for example, you can also use Excel. Now, Excel for sure has its own limitation, but you can use it also to represent some data or even analyze the data. But like for sure it doesn't have the full tool set available for you as other tools. Now, data science is growing rapidly. The estimated size of the current data science market size about $40 billion. In 2024, it's expected to reach about $140 billion, which indicates that there is a rapid growth in the data science community and the data science applications and users and so on. There are many. Okay, so hopefully you will jump on the wagon of like using data science inside your organization to analyze the data, know what's going on with your data, and like I guarantee to you it will get you many advanced use cases for you and your customer. Now, also, what we can tell you about data science. If you look online, there are many available data sets. If you are like maybe trying to learn data science and so on, there are many free online data sets that you can go learn and use to help you understand and like analyze the different models in data science now. And like many as well, many as well as available data from different organization, from different companies, they just give it to you for free to help you analyze your data, and so on. So this is for the data science part. Now, let's talk about big data. Now, when we talk about big data, what do we mean? We are talking about the insane amount of data that is, let's say, generated via the today world users. For example, there are videos like on YouTube, thousands of hours of videos are getting uploaded every day to YouTube. Now that's a lot of data, that's the big data. Now, what you wanna do with this big data? Now you can use maybe some data science tools and so on to analyze and take a look at these data and like, okay, many videos are getting uploaded from this area of the world because, okay, something maybe happened there. So big data is like, for me, I think it's the future, and it's where the actual technology advancement will be. Because today users generate massive amount of data. Now this data can leave traces somewhere. Okay, it leave like a trace. Like, hey, many users are maybe, or let's say many YouTubers are reviewing maybe this technology item. Okay, you can look at this and know that Maybe this item need to be in my e-commerce store, and so on. So there are many, let's say, useful information to help you with these data. Now, also, what I see is that the storage data, or the massive data storage, will be available online for everybody to help, and like for a cheap price. And it's already cheap, and I think it will get cheaper in the future, where you will be able to store data and like retrieve data from the cloud. Now, the data or the big data is like, it's growing insanely each and every day. There are many data like source and format are getting generated online each day. For example, text, images, videos, and so on. All these are getting uploaded online, and everybody are like either share them, use them, and so on. So the data, I think currently we live in the age of the raw data. Okay, we're not yet processing the data into information. Now, data by itself is just raw. Information is the processed data. Now, okay, we are in the information age, as they call it, but we still are producing too much data. And this data, a lot of time, it's not processed. So like, you create a blog post, so that blog post is online, okay, but as itself there, it's a data, Okay, now when it's get indexed by Google search engine and so on, it become an information and useful information. But I think currently we are not processing the data deeply enough. We are still scratching the top of the data and the information. For example, are we like, now if you go to Google, you just type a single term and it show you some related results. Now it can be related to the information you want or not, but what if the search engine started to get the more useful data for you, okay, and like try to connect the different dots or the different even the related topic to the same topic that you are searching for. Now they started to do something like that, but still, like, it's applied mostly in text, and like video, still we don't process it enough. Some beginnings are there where you can get maybe the results of a video or talks a certain topic like for you, but we still like way far behind. Now also like what of the person data, and that's a huge potential that advanced software is looking at. Now what if the person data started to be stored somewhere for everybody to be like accessed by him, like, or like he will authorize the access for that data, first thing first, but like it will be available to connect for everyone, for example. And that's an ongoing idea and thought in advanced software. Now let's say that I am in the UK, okay. Now I go to a hospital. Now this hospital, okay, it's like it registered my visit and so on and what the condition I have, and it's uploaded to some data store in the cloud, and that's totally fine. Now if I travel to the US, now the US hospital in the current day might not be able to know the information about my health condition that happened with me in the US. But when my data is available in some public data store, like for sure, again, like I know you're thinking privacy and so on, all these things can be handled. You can add some access, certain access level, or like give permissions for certain people to access your information and so on. So these things can be handled. But when you travel to the US and maybe you have a condition and so on, now the US hospital will be able to access the data for your file in the cloud and like see what you have. So you did not like lose a cycle and so on. So this can be really helpful. For example, you can like, let's say that you are in the UK and you do a blood test, and your blood test like blood type is maybe A+, and now you go maybe to Sweden and you get a car accident. Now when they rush you to the hospital, they can see that okay, he done in the UK a blood test and his blood type is A+. Okay, so now he is getting like the Sweden hospital can see your information and so on, and like responding to it. It doesn't need to do a new blood test for you, it just need to give you the correct blood type. Now hopefully nobody gets into a car accident. We don't need to see that use case in real life, hopefully. But this is as an example. So like this way, the data is no longer in a single place. Now you can travel the world freely. You have all your data in just a single place. For example, how many time, like let's say that you took an educational, you graduated from a university in a certain country. Now if you travel to another country, the first thing they will tell you, okay, go test your certificates. Now imagine that if your data is stored somewhere privately in a secure way on the cloud, and you just need to, you know what, you don't need to stamp a certificate. You just go there, you go to the university, and you just give them access to your data or send them your data. And this way, and this is what I believe is the future, maybe my personal opinion, but I think this is what we will see sooner or later. There will be no, like, let's call them, you will have some form of digital passport, you will have some form of digital identity. It will be a global one as well, so you don't need to spend all that time running, oh, I lost my passport. No, it just secured somewhere in the cloud, and you can access it everywhere. Now, all of that we talked about is related to the data, big data and data science. And like, this will open many, many doors for human beings, and like, we will see some really nice technology advancement. For example, I can now travel the world where I want. They will have all my medical information. Now, maybe some people do some wrong things. We don't know. Maybe they have some bad credit score and so on. All it will be stored in the cloud. They will be able to access it. Now, in the current day, there is some kind of access, but it takes a lot of time. It's messy. Doing an integration with the outside world, just especially with, if you are working for government agencies, it just, wow, just a nightmare. Okay, so these things hopefully in the future will go into the big data. It will be stored in some data warehouse somewhere. Now, I think each country will have its own data store and so on, and then other people will be able to access it, or other countries, and this will be much faster cycle. For example, if you wanna issue a visa for to travel to a certain country, maybe they need to check you and so on, and it can take 3, 4, 5, 7 days, okay? No, with the data and so on, okay, they just go on, type in your unique identifier, access your data from your home country, see like you're okay, and you get your visa within just a single hour. And that will open so much possibilities to the world and so on, even companies, and like, there are many, many cases for the data. Now, data is the future oil, okay? It is the future oil, and the person who will be able to analyze data, understand data, work with data and so on, able to store data and give the correct access to his data and so on to the outside world, I believe he will be the leading one. And in advanced software, we are working in creating some form of big data or for global access and so on around the world. Now, that was our own main topic and so on. Now, we have a book recommendation for you, which is Data Science for Dummies. Like the four dummies, there are, I remember there's machine learning, and I remember there is maybe big data for dummies as well. There is almost anything for dummies. there is like, how to scratch your back while doing a podcast for dummies book. They have almost a title like for everything. Okay, now anyways, but we thank them, they give some valuable knowledge for sure. Okay, now I recommend this book if you want to understand more about this subject, and I believe that this is the subject of the future, the data storage, because like, we are, the human being is like generating too much data. Even this podcast is a data. Even the YouTube video is a lot of data. And we are generating more and more and more data each and every day. and like just growing. It's not stopping. And the government's starting to what? To store their data, to get their data online, give online services, many countries around the world, and so on. So, if you wanna get ahead, you need to know how to store, retrieve, process your data, and make it as a useful information. So now, before we end this episode, as usual, we will give you our quote. And this episode quote: to be successful, you have to have your heart in business and your business in your heart. And that is something really, really important for anybody who's starting his business, his work, and so on. So like and even like advanced software, although like it's still a growing company, we're still really small comparing other giants, but we have like I have the founder of advanced software and so on, I always think about advanced software, how I can get it, how I can make it bigger, how I can make it better, and so on. So all these things always goes into my mind, and I hope that you do the same thing for your business as well. So I would like to thank you for watching and coming throughout this another show or another episode from the Advanced Business Show. Hopefully you like my new shirt color. It matches the, you see this background couch, sorry. It matches its color, so I wore it. Okay, hopefully you like it. So I thank you again for watching, and I hope I will see you again in the next episode from the Advanced Business Show.